It's AumSum time!
What if there were no holidays?
Don't worry, AumSum will never let this happen.
Wow, AumSum. Firstly, with no holidays, people might get depressed. Psychologists will have a lot of work on their hand. Secondly, with no holidays, people will be working without any break. Their health may suffer. Hospital visits and sick leaves will take a huge jump. Thirdly, families come together on holidays. With no holidays, families might grow apart over a period of time. Fourthly, with no holidays, people might forget how to have fun anymore. Life might become dull and boring. Fifthly, with no holidays, tourism industry all around the world will suffer. Restaurants will close. Jobs will be lost. Lastly, with no holidays, productivity might take a dip as people may not be energetic enough or not in the right state of mind to work productively. What if there were no schools?
Then I will start my AumSum online classes.
Wow, AumSum. Firstly, with no schools, kids will be at home all day. Parents will probably have no idea what to do with them. Secondly, with no schools, movie theaters and theme parks will be crowded all day long. Thirdly, with no schools, online learning will become extremely popular. Fourthly, with no schools, parents will start teaching their kids. Teachers will have to look for new jobs. Fifthly, with no schools, kids will probably have no future career plans. Career counselors will have a tough task in front of them. Lastly, with no schools, there will be no grades or report cards. Employers will have to recruit people based on their practical skills. On the flip side, with no schools, outdoor games will become more popular. Kids will probably become more physically healthy. What if aliens visited us?
Now, what if I am an alien? I am already here.
Oh, AumSum. Firstly, this would mean that the aliens are significantly advanced technologically as compared to us. Secondly, it is quite possible that aliens may possess cloaking technology and thus they may remain invisible to us. Thirdly, if the intention of the aliens is to dominate us, then all human beings will have to come together in order to have any chance of winning or surviving. Fourthly, if the aliens are nice-minded creatures, then we humans might be able to learn a lot from them, both about science as well as about the universe. Fifthly, there's a chance of an infection being passed on either way. Social distancing will be the way to go forward. Lastly, animals will surely be hoping that at least the aliens will be sensitive towards the environment. What if you were the last person on Earth?
Wow! All the pizzas and burgers only for me!
Oh, AumSum. Firstly, you would no doubt be the loneliest person on Earth. Secondly, there would be no more borders. In fact, no more countries anymore. The entire world will be yours to roam. Thirdly, it will be a good thing if you are an animal lover. Else you will have a hard time as there will be no one else for company. Fourthly, fresh food will be extremely hard to come by. But preserved and canned food will last for many a lifetimes. Fifthly, you will probably forget how to speak in a few years' time as there will be no human to speak with. Lastly, you'll have to avoid injuries and keep yourself in the best of health as there will be no more doctors to help you out. What if there was no electricity?
Then I will electrify everything using my electric dance.
Oh, AumSum. Firstly, no TVs, mobiles, ACs, refrigerators. Life as we know it will be turned upside down. Secondly, the world has grown closer due to electronic communication such as emails, voice calls, messengers, etc. With no electricity, communication with far-off people will become a far-off dream. Thirdly, with no electricity, nights will become dark again. The good old candle might make a comeback. Fourthly, with no electricity, all modern cars will be rendered useless. Steam engines might make a comeback. People will start riding horses again. Lastly, with no electricity, computers will stop operating. World will go back to the good old ways of using books to keep records. On the flip side, with no electricity, pollution levels all around the world will reduce drastically. What if you had $1 trillion?
I already have them. My only problem is what to do with them.
Oh, AumSum. $1 trillion is 1 followed by 12 zeros. If you had $1 trillion, firstly, you don't need to work anymore. You would be the richest person in the world, and that too by a huge margin. Secondly, one can buy a 1-bedroom apartment for $1 million in San Francisco. With $1 trillion, one could buy an apartment for everybody in the city. Thirdly, there's supposed to be 1 trillion species in the world. With $1 trillion, you could give $1 to every species. Lastly, $1 weighs 1 gram. $1 trillion weigh around 2.2 billion pounds, or about 600,000 cars. Good luck with carrying your $1 trillion. What if humans were immortal?
No big deal. I am already immortal.
Oh, AumSum. Firstly, planet Earth will be overflown by humans, as nobody will die. Population control will be the single biggest issue worldwide. Secondly, only immortality is promised, but being healthy will be individual person's responsibility. Healthcare will become the biggest industry in the world. Thirdly, this will be sad news for many animal species. Very few will be able to survive this human onslaught. Fourthly, many people will be under no hurry to accomplish something in life. Creativity might take a huge dip. Fifthly, many people will probably get bored as they will have no idea what to do after a few hundred years. Also, with so much time on hand, interstellar travel like the one seen in Star Wars might become a reality. Lastly, cemeteries and graveyards will be shut down worldwide. What if everybody started living underground?
Then I will start a hole digging company and earn a lot of money.
Wow, AumSum. Firstly, nature will quickly reclaim its rightful place. Trees and bushes will start shooting out of buildings and factories. Animals living on land will be one happy lot. Secondly, one-time cost of building homes and roads underground will be extremely high. Thirdly, getting enough oxygen underground for everybody will be a huge challenge. Fourthly, tsunamis and storms will not bother us anymore. But earthquakes and volcanoes might pose a bigger threat. Fifthly, air conditioners will be in huge demand, as there will be very little wind underground. Also, we will be unwelcome guests as we will be trespassing the territory of snakes, earthworms, and ants. Lastly, people will really start to miss sunrise, sunset, rain, as well as clear skies. What if we build a space elevator?
Nah, I will take the stairs. I like to remain fit.
Wow, AumSum. Space elevator is a planet-to-space transportation system. It allows vehicles from Earth's surface to directly enter into space or orbit without the use of large rockets. Firstly, space elevators will be great news for space agencies around the world. Why? Rockets currently used to launch satellites use a lot of fuel. Also, it is very expensive to add extra weight to satellites. Secondly, one-time cost of building a space elevator would be extremely high, but it will prove to be cost-effective in the long run. Thirdly, neither the Taj Mahal nor the Eiffel Tower, but space elevator will be the hottest tourist destination. Lastly, one of the biggest dreams of bungee jumpers around the world would be to bungee jump from the space elevator. What if humans were cold-blooded?
Easy peasy. I'm already cold-blooded.
What? Oh, AumSum. Warm-blooded creatures, like birds and mammals, can maintain a body temperature which is higher than their environment. While cold-blooded animals, like reptiles and fishes, cannot regulate their internal temperature. It actually varies based on external temperature. Now, if humans were cold-blooded, firstly, sunbathing would become extremely popular, because cold-blooded animals need to first warm up in order to remain active. Secondly, tourism would take a big hit, as it is not easy for a cold-blooded animal to easily adjust to different climatic conditions like a warm-blooded animal does. Thirdly, restaurant industry will suffer as cold-blooded animals require much less food as well as energy. On the flip side, as less bacteria and viruses can survive in low temperatures, there will be less chance of infection to us.